quick hit.
It's time for Hobby Quick Hits.
Hobby Quick Hits.
A sports card podcast where we tackle the hobby's hottest topics in depth to help you navigate the sports card landscape and enjoy the hobby we all love. Here's your host, John Newman.
All right, welcome to another edition of Hobby Quick Hits. Today's episode, the NFL Rookie Report through 6 weeks. So, you know, a lot of people know I'm a huge football guy. I actually do an NFL podcast called Roughing the Passer with Beckett's David Lee and my son Jordan Newman, Sunday nights, 9:30 p.m. Eastern Time, live, and then we release the audio version Monday or Tuesday. Shameless plug there. But huge football guy, kind of know my stuff, coached it for the 2 cents that's worth. And so I get a lot of times, because some folks know that, I get a lot of football questions. I watch a lot of football. I've done these kind of shows before. I wanted to do the 2021 sort of the... We're kind of a little more than one third through the season, kind of just forecast, talk about some of the rookie performances so far. Not from the sports side. I mean, I'm going to come at it from a sports side, but obviously, performance is directly related to card prices, right? So we're going to talk about what guys are solid to buy, maybe who to avoid, if you will. Obviously, my opinions are my own. Everything is speculation. I'm not always right. Even though I might be football educated, sometimes I'm wrong. I thought Kyler Murray wasn't going to be that good. I think we can safely say right now he's a Pro Bowler, and they're 6-0 and looking like a Super Bowl contender. So I'm not always right, but I like to think I'm more wrong or more right than more wrong. And so we're going to kind of go through this year's rookie class through 6 weeks of the NFL season and talk about what we've seen thus far. But before we do, let's hear from our great sponsor, Mojo Breaks. After that, we'll start the show. Hey folks, wanted to tell you about the best place to get some of your sealed sports card wax products. Great selection and some of the lowest prices on the web. MojoBreakShop.com is that place. Whether it's a box or a whole case, they're your guys, and they ship around the world right to your door. The Mojo Break name is one of the most trusted in the hobby. From sports cards to Pokemon, their selection can't be beat. They offer daily deals and pre-orders. Who won first place at this year's Topps Rip Party? None other than Mojo Break. Their prices are already great, but here's a way to save even more money. Use the code QUICKHITS, that's QUICKHITS, for 10% off anything on MojoBreakShop.com. They also have a full-service card shop in Santa Clara, California. So if you're in the area, stop by. They're open 7 days a week, so check them out at MojoBreakShop.com. So we're going to go over some of the rookie performances so far through 6 weeks of the season. It's going to be definitely heavy offense, obviously, right? Chicks dig touchdowns and receiving yards and big runs, right? But all joking aside, it's going to be heavy offense. I may mention a defensive guy or two, but we're going to talk about, obviously, your quarterbacks, your receivers, and your running backs. I'm not going to go and talk about a million people. I'm going to really key on the ones that have kind of had standout performances. Now, that being said, remember, just because I don't mention a guy on this episode doesn't mean they can't be future Hall of Famers or Pro Bowlers. We're looking at a guy this year for the Cowboys, Trevon Diggs, right? Second-year defensive player. Had an okay rookie year, right? Was coming out of nowhere this year. 7 interceptions. Going to be going to the Pro Bowl and looking like one of the best secondary players in the league. If, you know, when I did this show last year, wouldn't be talking about him, right? So people can emerge, right, in any sport, but we're talking about football here. So just because I don't mention someone, you know, if you like somebody, just because I don't mention them doesn't mean that potentially they can't be, you know, a Pro Bowler, you know, a Pro Bowler, a Hall of Famer, and that sort of thing. So, you know, whether I mention someone you're fond of, don't read too much into it. I'm going to try to keep this show to about 20, 25 minutes, maybe less. And so I want to hit the key guys that, to me, have the greatest potential to be, you know, long-term players in the NFL. All right, let's start with what's generally considered the sexiest position on the football field. It's what we sort of judge draft classes by every year, right? Quarterback class. This year's class, pretty deep, as typical of the last few years. We've got Justin Fields, Trevor Lawrence, the number one pick, Trey Lance, Zach Wilson, and Mac Jones. You know, generally, in most draft classes of late, you got about four or five first-round quarterback draft picks, and what we tend to see is three sort of make it, and two sort of don't. Or, in some bad years, maybe sort of flip it, right? Three don't make it, and two are either, you know, serviceable or very good, right? Trevor Lawrence, the number one pick, you know, obviously been called transcendent. Some early struggles, right? We see him, you know, throwing a little more interceptions than we sort of expected to see him. Didn't make a lot of mistakes at Clemson, but, you know, this is a whole new level. There are 11, you know, pro players on the other side he's got to look at now, rather than three or four, potentially less, than he saw in college. So, you know, he's again, rookie quarterbacks tend to struggle sometimes. I don't be too quick to write him off. I think he's you know, if I'm ranking him, I know he's the number one pick, but I still rank him as the best quarterback in this class. Another guy I like is Trey Lance. He's seen some spot work in the 49ers, but got his first start last week. Struggled a little bit, but again, young quarterback. But they really do like him there. I like the intangibles he brings, and I think the Jimmy G era is going to come to a close here pretty soon. I like Trey Lance a lot, too. I think he's dynamic. I think he's young. He's raw. It's why he wasn't talked a lot about. But he's also why the 49ers traded up and made him their guy. So I think next year will be the year for him. I think he's going to learn a little bit this year. But he is going to play this year as well. And I think the Jimmy G era, like I said, is on the borrowed time. Staying with quarterbacks, Justin Fields, I like, out of Ohio State. I don't know if he's going to be a great quarterback. I think he could be a good quarterback. I don't know even how to explain why I feel that way. I just sort of do. Continuing on, a guy I like but don't love, Mac Jones. He's actually playing pretty well in New England. Under the tutelage of Bill Belichick and Josh McDaniels. And that's where I'm going with this. He might be a, you know, and I know Brady's great, arguably the all-time greatest quarterback, but I think you can be a system quarterback in New England. We saw Matt Cassel have success there. Anyone that's played there, with maybe the exception of Cam Newton recently, has actually been pretty successful. And that's my point. I think he's going to be a good quarterback, not a great quarterback. When we talk about the hobby, right? Great quarterbacks do well hobby-wise, hobby love. And good quarterbacks, You know what I mean? Hit or miss. So I just see him sort of as the Patriots system quarterback. He'll put up some halfway decent numbers, but not gaudy. Not a guy I would go nuts collecting. But again, to each their own. I'm only speaking for myself on this show. Last guy I want to talk about from the quarterback position, and that's Zach Wilson. And I said it before the draft, I think the Jets reached, much like the Giants did with Daniel Jones a few years back. They fell in love with some highlights, but they didn't watch the whole game. And I don't think Zach Wilson has the makeup for New York City. I think the guy they got rid of, Sam Darnold, who had his struggles in New York, was actually a better player. They just didn't work out in New York. And so Zach Wilson's going to be, to me, I'm gonna put him as the bust pick. He's struggling now. He's got a lot of picks. He's forcing the ball in, not making good decisions. And he's a guy, I said before the draft, somebody has to fail. I wish no one fails, but somebody has to. And he's my pick. And right now, he's earning that billing. So he's a guy I would really avoid, personally, unless you're a Jets fan and you just collect Jets. But I just, you know, every quarterback drafted can't make it, right? We know that. That's not breaking news there. So, and he's my guy. All right, enough of quarterbacks. Let's move to running backs this year. I'm only going to mention two. Some people are going to be disappointed with that. Obviously, there's more than two rookie running backs in the NFL. I'm going to just talk about two in particular. You know, I'm going to be a homer here. Najee Harris is the real deal. He's on my favorite team, the Steelers. Love him. Finally getting some running game back in Pittsburgh. But he's not just a guy that's going to take a handoff. He's proven that he's going to be a pass catcher out of the backfield and is one of the leading Steeler receivers as far as catches go, and proven very versatile. The only thing I'll be honest with you and worrying about him is he's getting a lot of action. He doesn't come out of games. He's touching the ball a high percentage of the offensive plays in this offense, and that wear and tear can add up. We see sort of what Le'Veon Bell is today compared to what he was even 3-4 years ago, which was arguably the best back in football, and sitting out a year and carrying the ball a ton, he's kind of been a shell of his former self. I'm not saying that Najee projects the same exact way, but that risk is always there when someone gets that, touches the ball that much. I love him. He's a guy that I've been buying, but little disclaimer there, I am a Steeler fan, so I'm buying him sort of inherently as a Steeler fan. Remember, running back shelf life, 2 to 4 years a lot of times, right? With very rare exceptions, you know, and so just tread carefully. The other guy I want to talk about is a guy that's not lighting it up this year, I like him long term. Another guy can catch the ball out of the backfield and run it, kind of a scat back, Kenneth Gainwell. Kenneth Gainwell that's on Philadelphia. He's got 21 carries for 100 yards, 15 catches for 123 more. He's not lighting the world on fire, but he's also not the feature back yet. He's playing behind Miles Sanders. But he's a guy that long-term, he's cheap to buy now. So you can kind of pick him up sort of cheaply. And if you don't mind waiting a little bit, it might pay dividends. You got Michael Carter with the Jets. You got Trey Sermon with the 49ers. Again, running backs are sort of, I hate to say it like this, sort of a dime or dozen with the rare exception. So we're not going to spend a lot of time in that room. Okay, let's move on to receivers. I think the best receiver in this class is the guy playing the best right now. as a rookie. That's Ja'Marr Chase. 23 catches, 456 yards, 5 touchdowns. Had some early drop troubles in the preseason, in the first game or two of the regular season. Has worked those out and has fixed those things and has become a deep threat, vertical threat for his former college teammate and roommate in Joe Burrow. And these guys, I'm going to say it, these guys could have one of those famous connections, right? You know, we've all heard Montana the Rice, and also, you know, this could be Burrow the Chase for a long time to come. I really, you know, I don't like praising guys in the Steelers division, but I'm going to be honest here. Ja'Marr Chase is the real deal. Another guy, Jalen Waddle, with Miami. You know, 27 catches, 231 yards, 2 TDs. I like him as well. Sort of got the build and the makeup to be a solid receiver. Devonta Smith, also from Alabama, like Waddle. 27 catches, 345 yards with the Eagles. I like him too. I know he had some, you know, a lot of people question his size. He's a Heisman winner. He can play. I don't think he's going to be Ja'Marr Chase, but I think he's going to be a pretty good wide receiver in the NFL. I don't know if Jalen Hurts is the guy long-term in Philly, but that's what he's got to work with right now. I want to talk about another guy who's listed as a tight end, but this guy really plays like a wide receiver. Kyle Pitts in Atlanta, I love him. 24 catches, 308 yards, 1 touchdown. Some early struggles, but he's starting to pick it up. Again, long term, I think he's going to be an all-pro, especially if he's classified as a tight end, because he's going to put up wide receiver-type numbers from the tight end position. So he's a guy, I think you can still get him fairly cheaply, and he's a guy I would consider buying and kind of socking away. I think long-term that could pay dividends. I mentioned at the top of the show I wasn't going to talk about defensive guys too much, but I do want to give an honorable mention to probably the guy that's going to win Defensive Rookie of the Year, and that's Micah Parsons in Dallas, who's playing very well. You know, one of the reasons, obviously, we're not going to talk a lot about defensive guys in a show like this one is because, you know, hobby-wise, defensive guys don't get always a lot of love. But I did want to mention Micah Parsons in this episode. So there you go. There's the rookie report, hobby rookie report, after 6 weeks of the NFL season. All right, thank you for listening to another episode of Hobby Quick Hits. Want to give out our social media, starting with our website, which is www.sportscardnationpodcast.com. Facebook, you can follow us at www.facebook.com/sportscardnationpodcast/. Twitter, we are at sportscardnati1, so it's sportscardnati1. Instagram, at sportscardnationpodcast, or you can email the show hobbyquickhits@gmail.com. Again, thanks for listening. We'll see you next week.
So long, farewell. I'll be just saying adieu.
Adieu, adieu to you and you and you.